Today I am going to explain about projection of points. Projection of points are the points which are used to differentiate the locations in different quadrants. So here I am explaining about the topic from engineering drawing, projection of points. Before going to explain about the projection of points, we need to know what are the projections. First, you take an object, say it is a triangle. From the triangle, if you project a light or a torch light from this direction, we call as observer direction, and a light is, the image will be falling on a screen, will be calling that is as a projection by passing through the lines. These lines are called as projectors. So basically the projections will be divided into three parts. One is projection, and another one is projector, and third one is projectors. This is called as final projection. So before going to have the projection of points, we need to know about quadrants. So here the basic quadrants are four quadrants, and we will be dividing these four quadrants with principal planes. So here there are two principal planes. One is called as horizontal plane, another one is called as vertical plane. So these two principal planes are divided in mutually perpendicular, that is the angle of 90 degrees. Now the vertical plane simply will be calling as vertical plane, that is VP, and the horizontal plane as HP. So these two planes always mutually perpendicular. And suppose you consider the first quadrant, we have two principal planes divided in first quadrant as well as in second quadrant and third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So if you consider first quadrant, suppose a point P, for example, a point P is located in first quadrant at a distance of, say, x distance from the vertical plane and y distance from the horizontal plane. And if you want to locate the projections, we need to see the direction of z, that is called as observer direction. If you see the direction of z, the object P will be projected on the vertical plane and it will be marked as P dash. And if you see, to draw the projections from the vertical direction, that is from the top view, it will be projecting on horizontal plane and it will be represented as P. In order to draw these first quadrant projections in a graphical representation on a drawing sheet, we need to draw the horizontal plane and vertical plane, and it will be separated by means of a reference line called as XY line. So here this is called as XY line, and above the XY line in first quadrant we'll get the vertical plane, and below the XY line we're getting horizontal plane, and the line representing will be called as projector. So the projector will be drawn at a distance of x from the XY line and y from the XY line on horizontal plane, and front view will be called as P dash, that is on the vertical plane, and P will be called as top view and it will be on the horizontal plane in case of first quadrant. Suppose you take point Q in a second quadrant, how it will be and how it will be represented. Say point Q is at a distance of, in terms of, now you can take as a values 20 mm from the vertical plane and 15 mm from the horizontal plane. So now we will be drawing the projections of point Q in second quadrant in a drawing sheet for the solution. So the problem is, a point Q is 20 mm from the vertical plane and 15 mm from the horizontal plane. Say it is a second quadrant, we will be considering a point Q is behind the vertical plane and above the horizontal plane. the solution will be, we'll be drawing horizontal plane and vertical plane as of it is the first quadrant. But in the case of second quadrant, we need to rotate the horizontal plane as clockwise direction on both sides, so that the vertical plane and the horizontal plane are overlapped, and both views, front view and top view, will be coming above the XY line. So that is Q dash and Q, both will be coming above the XY line. So Q dash, that is front view, will be 15 mm above the horizontal plane, and Q, that is top view, 20 mm from the horizontal plane. This is about second quadrant. Now we will see about third quadrant. Say third quadrant, for example, point S will be represented. When you want to see a point in third quadrant, we will be seeing below the horizontal plane and behind the vertical plane. When you see the terms below the horizontal plane and behind the vertical plane, it will be third quadrant. And when you rotate the horizontal plane in clockwise direction, it will be the above the horizontal plane will come above the XY line, and vertical plane will be coming below the XY line. XY line will be the reference line. Now we will see the solution for the point S. When you draw the front view will be coming below the XY line, and it will be called as S dash, and the top view will be small s. The distances from the vertical plane and the horizontal plane for point S will be 25 mm each from the two reference lines. Say it will be 25 mm from the XY line and 25 mm from the horizontal plane and 25 mm from the vertical plane. Now if you see a point R, a point R in fourth quadrant. So when you want to have a point, projection of point in a fourth quadrant, so we will be drawing, rotating horizontal plane in clockwise direction. So the horizontal plane and vertical plane both will be coming below the XY line. Both views will be coming below the XY line. So we will be drawing the solution for point R in fourth quadrant. So two planes, that is horizontal plane and a vertical plane, are overlapping each other. When we draw the solution for small r, the representation of projection will be small r. R dash will be front view and R will be top view. So the distances between the point location, that is 30 mm from the vertical plane and 15 mm from the horizontal plane. Now you draw the solution, the top view, that is the 15 mm from the XY line, and the front view, that is 30 mm from the XY line in fourth quadrant. So all these four quadrants will be drawn for projection of points. Now if you see overall representation of the points in each quadrant, now you draw one single XY line, and we will be comparing all four representations of first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant, and we will see what are the views and how we will be getting the views in each quadrant. Now we will see the first quadrant. The vertical plane will be coming above the XY line, and the horizontal plane will be coming below the XY line, and the view that is drawn on the vertical plane will be front view, and the view that is drawn on the horizontal plane, that is top view. So here the two views will be separated by means of a XY line. If you go for the second quadrant, in the second quadrant when you rotate the horizontal plane, so both will be overlapped and they will be coming above the XY line, that is vertical plane will be above the XY line and horizontal plane also will be above the XY line, and even the views, front view and top views, both will be above the XY line. So in the case of third quadrant, third quadrant will be rotating the horizontal plane in a clockwise direction, and it will be above the xy line. So when you compare the front first quadrant and the third quadrant, the both are mutually opposite. So in third quadrant, horizontal plane will be coming above the xy line and vertical plane will be coming below the xy line. So horizontal plane will be top view, as we will be seeing, and the front view will be on vertical plane. But when you compare the first quadrant and third quadrant, in first quadrant the front will be above the xy line, in third quadrant front will be below the xy line. As well as in fourth quadrant, if you see, when you rotate the horizontal plane in clockwise direction, both planes will be overlap and will be getting horizontal plane as well as vertical plane, both are below the xy line, and here two views will be overlap and will be getting the front view and top view, both are below xy line. Thank you.